Welcome again to this week's episode of The Royce. It is here in The Royce where we discuss issues that are going to help our young people sail through these the years that are very critical, that are very important in their lives. Last week, we were discussing a very important topic that was lost and lonely. And there are a few things that we spoke. I want to believe that you subscribe or you listened, and now we want to go to the next part of the same topic on how do you beat loneliness and find yourself? Because we talked that we need Christ to help us and to guide us. And number one person to help yourself come out of loneliness is yourself. And we also talked about that our parents have a role, our churches have a role, and our nation have a role. We will discuss about all this later in this place. But today we are talking about ourselves. How can we help ourselves to come out of this black hole and come out on the other side as victorious and also accomplish our purpose on earth? You find that in the book of Judges, chapter 2, there is where God... the Bible says that when Joshua died and all the leaders that were with him, there arose a generation that did not know God, a generation that did not come with them from Egypt. So they had not seen much of the miracles that God had done for the children of Israel. They never saw the parting of the Red Sea. They never saw manna in the wilderness. And therefore, they had not known God as the way God would have wanted them to know him. And therefore, there were times they could mess, there were times they could go away from God's ways, and God was annoyed with them. And God said, the way he had fought battles for the children of Israel, he could drive away nations ahead of them. Mungu akasema, I will leave some nations. I will not drive them away so that these children can know how to fight. I may be able to teach them war and how to depend on me and how to follow my ways and statutes so that they can be able to reach their destiny, to fight for their blessings, to fight for their destiny until they get to Canaan. And in the book of Judges 2, the Bible says, when all that generation had been gathered to their fathers, another generation arose after them who did not know the Lord, nor the work which he had done for Israel. They did not cease from their own doings, nor from their stubborn ways. Then the Bible says in verse 20, then the anger of the Lord was hot against Israel. Why? God becomes very annoyed when you don't follow his ways, when you don't follow his commandments. He loves you so much and he'd want to guide you through your ears to the time now you become an adult. So allow Christ in your life that he may be able to guide you. Chapter 3 of the Judges also said, all those who had not known any of the war in Canaan, these are the people God wanted to teach. This was only so that the generation of the children of Israel might be taught to know war, at least those who had not formally known it. So, Mungu ndiye anatufunza kupigania maisha yetu. At times you enter a time or a season and you don't know what is happening. Maybe you are in Form 4, you are in high school, and if challenges are many at home, even at home you are not able to get all that you need. And you say, if God can help me just to do Form 4, and I get to the university, I will find that life is good there. But you only to get to the university and find there are more challenges there. Every step of life, stage of life, has its own challenges. Why? God has set it like that we may be able to know how to depend on him, to trust him, to obey him, to walk in his ways, that he may teach us how to fight for our destinies, how to fight for our dreams, how to fight for our joy and peace of mind, that we may be able to accomplish his purpose on earth. It is the same way that God does for us. A problem-free life is a mirage in the desert. You'll always find problems. You'll always find challenges. But the way you handle them, it is what you determine whether you will be able to become what God desires you to be, or you will become an addict and thrown somewhere in a rehab. It is your choice. It is at this time that you have the opportunity to make the good choice that will help you become who God created you to be. May the Lord bless you, and may the Lord help you even to make the right choices, even in this age. 13 to 21 years, we said, is like a never lad, you know, a lad that somebody want to just pass through quickly. It's like a black hole. But I declare and decree that Christ is going to help you come out of this hole, come out of this stage victorious. Even you will walk in the ways of God, and you are going to attain your destiny. You are going to be attain your dream that are great in God. God bless you. Praying for you here in the Royce. We love you. We pray for you. At this time, as you continue to stay at home, in this time of pandemic, may the Lord help you even to have time to pray, have time to read the Word of God the way you have been taught by your teachers in school, even the way you normally go for your Sunday services, and we get you there. The way you even have your weekly challenges, I want to congratulate our parents, our teachers. They do a great job even when you are in your school. They guide you in the ways of God. So make sure you don't waste yourself. Pull yourself back and walk in God's ways. God bless you. Until the next time.